Stress is when you have a lot on your plate. But in this situation, you would be stressed if you had no food on the plate because that would mean you were starving. But the actual definition of stress is a state of mental or emotional strain or tension resulting from adverse or very demanding circumstances. So, like this final exam.
As you can see by this cute little diagram I found in Healthline magazine, almost every part of your body is affected by stress in some way. For example, stress causes changes in your respiratory system, so if you have a pre-existing condition like asthma, things can get pretty bad pretty quick. Stress can also cause type 2 diabetes, erectile dysfunction, high blood pressure, and infertility.
Okay, there are a lot of physical effects of stress, but there are also a lot of mental and emotional ones too. Too much stress can cause depression, bipolar disorder, and anxiety disorder. It can also alter the operations and structure of the nervous system. Neurons don't function normally, especially in the frontal lobe, which can affect our ability to pay attention, filter our unnecessary info, and use our problem-solving skills. Being stressed for long periods of time can also cause changes in our personality, like aggression, excessive lying, social withdrawal, and decreased concern with punctuality.
I think just about everyone has learned about or at least heard of fight or flight, but just for kicks, the definition of fight or flight is the activation of the sympathetic nervous system in response to a stressful event, preparing the body to fight or flee. Adrenaline kicks in, your breathing picks up, and pupils dilate, so basically your body instinctively prepares you to fight or run for your life, which is pretty cool.
One of the most well-known stress disorders is PTSD, or post-traumatic stress disorder. The most general definition of PTSD is the inability to recover after experiencing a traumatic event. Often you hear about PTSD in combat veterans. There are four major symptoms of PTSD. One is reliving the event, two, avoiding situations that remind you of the event, three, having more negative beliefs and feelings, four, feeling keyed up or hyper aroused. What causes you stress?
This project and class.
Oh, lots of things. Like, waking up on time causes me stress.
Just kidding, I can't do this.
One of the things would be kids.
My job.
You cause me stress.
I suffer from lots of stressors, such as girls.
Like, money.
I get home, it's my kids, when they say, Mom, Mom, you forgot, Mom, come do this, Mom, Mom, Mom.
How do you alleviate stress?
I tase students at Millard High School.
No. I love to watch animal videos on Facebook.
I read a book, or I watch Netflix, or I just take a nap, because that's pretty jazzy. That's pretty cool.
Oh, you better stop. I don't know.
Scream in frustration and throw things.
Good answer.
Like cats. I got a cat tattoo. I have fake ones. How does your body react to stress?
I don't know. I've never tested that theory.
I get really, really ornery, like scary ornery.
Gee, sweating.
Going?
Yes!
Oh. How does your body react to stress?
My hair falls out a lot. I get a really bad hump neck pain. I call it my hump neck.
Not very well. I tend to overeat and drink a lot of pop.
I get the runs.
I know I'm not the only one who spent so long attempting to be someone else. Well, I'm over it. I don't care if the world knows what my secrets are. Secrets are. Sometimes I cry a whole day. I care a lot. Use an analog clock and never know when to stop. And I'm passive aggressive. I'm scared of the dark and the dentist. I love my butt and won't shut up. And I never